أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Again a question mark. Which way do you want to go? If you want to go towards the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so make haste, sabiqu ila maghfiratin min rabbikum. Compete with one another. Race with one another to get the forgiveness of your Lord and to get the garden, the breadth of which is like the breadth and vastness of the heaven and the earth. وَعِدَّتْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. It has been prepared for those who believe in Allah and His messengers. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُوتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. It is the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will grant it to whomsoever He will like. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. And definitely, Allah has infinite bounty, immense bounty. So this is the path is fixed now. But on this path, there might be tests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to go to the real path of Muhammad and his companions, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. They had the test. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. At every step. Harder and harder, severer and severer tests coming one after the other. But to be able to go through them, you have to keep one thing in view. And that is the necessary corollary of faith in Allah. What is it? مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِن قَبْلِ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا. Whatever affliction comes to you, either on a larger scale in the land, there are floods or something else of that sort, hurricane. But la fi anfusikum, or in your own, you become sick, you meet an accident or whatsoever. Illa fi kitab, all these things are already written in a book. Min qabli an nabraha, before we produce them and bring it forth. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. This is very easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the foreknowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not the predestination, foreknowledge. Allah knows what will happen to you. And whatsoever will happen to you will be by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we read in Surah Tawbah, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا. Nothing can come on us except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for us already, and He is our Mawla. Whatever comes from Him, well, welcome. Whatever comes from Him, it's welcome for me. لِكَيْ لَا تَعْصَوْ عَلَىٰ مَا فَاتَكُمْ. So that you should not grieve for that which you lose, and not rejoice on what Allah gives you. If you have lost something, this is also a test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you are patient, you endure it, and whatever Allah gives you, it's again a test. Whether you are thankful, and you use it properly, according to the divine law, and to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both ways, it's equal. So don't be grieved on what you have lost. Be patient. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. All praise be to Allah in all the conditions. Whatever has come to me from Allah, it's okay. I accept it. I welcome it. If He has given something to you, okay. Thank Him. Use it in the best way for your own benefit of the hereafter and for the benefit of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu la yuhibbu kulla mukhtalin fakhur. And Allah does not at all like those who are arrogant and who get over delighted by these worldly things. You got something and you feel over delighted. Allah doesn't like this. الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ وَيَعْمُرُونَ مَعَثَ بِالْبُخْلِ. Such are the people who are niggardly, covetous. They don't want to spend for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know the honor and respect in this world is for the wealthy, for the rich. So keep the wealth with you, so that your honor and respect, you know, that is intact. وَيَعْمُرُونَ مَعَثَ بِالْبُخْلِ. And they advise and suggest others also to be niggardly. Oh, you should be mindful of your future. What are you doing? You are spending everything for the deen of Allah. What will happen tomorrow? Maybe there is some emergency comes to you. What will you do? Your own sons and daughters? You don't think about their education, their marriages, etc., etc. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّ فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. And whosoever turns away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is self-sufficient. Ghani, He doesn't need anything from anybody. If He wants a loan from you, it's only to see how faithful you are. He doesn't actually need it. And He is Hamid, the praiseworthy. Now comes the real axis of this surah. And in a way, the real axis, umud, of the whole of Quran. This insight into the deen, which is lacking today. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Verily we sent our messengers with clear signs and proofs and clear teachings. بَيِّنَات, something which is self-evident, doesn't need any other proof. So the miracles were also bayyanat. And the basic teachings of all the scriptures, all the books of Allah, are also bayyanat. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلْنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانِ. And we sent with them, sent down the book, the law, and the balance. Symbol of justice. What for? Most important part of this ayah. لَيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. So that the people should abide by justice. Not they should read and get sawab. And they should listen to the Qari sahab in Taraweeh and get sawab. Is that all the purpose for which Quran was sent? Or you can read it very beautifully. And there are contests of qiraat, husn qiraat. Was this the purpose for which Quran was sent? Or you write down with golden wires. Is the purpose of Quran? Beautiful calligraphy. Was this the purpose of sending down Quran? What is it? Now see, the purpose of the advent of the messengers, the purpose of the sending down of the books, Purpose. It's not an exercise in futility. Alas, no action is purposeless. So all this, why? Sending messengers, sending down books, giving law and the balance. What for? لَيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. So that justice should be established and people should abide by justice. Now you know, where there is injustice, there are two classes, the exploiters and the exploited, the oppressors and the oppressed. the downtrodden and the haughty. Will these exploiters or oppressors or the haughty ever like that the system of justice be established? Will they be ready to lose their all the whatever they have in this wrong system? Privileges? No. They are bound to resist. There will be some whose arwah and qulub are saleem and safe. They will listen to your call and come to you. But not most of them. Most of the exploiters, oppressors, they will resist. They are bound to resist. They will say, gird up your loins, come on. Stand up to protect your interests and your privileges. So there is going down, there will definitely going to be a conflict. And for that, وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدِ, we have sent down iron. فِيهَ بَاسٌ شَدِيدٌ. In this iron is the capability of fighting, battle, weaponry, the sword and spears. وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ. There are other benefits for people also. Utensils or something or articles of use you can make. But actually this is, there is a view that iron and its compounds, they don't belong to this earth originally. They have come from the space. As meteorites, أَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدِ, we have sent down Hadeed. If that theory is correct, that this word will shine, you know, like anything. The Quran used this word for Hadith, أَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدِ. We sent down Hadith. If this is true, I'm not very sure. But I have heard this, that this view is there, that this iron and its compounds, they are not from this earth, they are from the space. As meteorites, they have come. So now this is وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدِ, and we have sent down iron, فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ, in which there is a very powerful capability of fighting and going to battle. وَلَيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ وَرُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ. And so that Allah wants to know, wants to see, who are those faithful servants of His who take this iron in hand and crush the heads of those who resist the establishment of the system of justice. And the system of justice is Islam. Inna deena inna lahi al-Islam. The al-haq, the total justice is Allah. Al-adl. He is the justice. Al-adl is one of the names. Only He can give you the just political, socio-economic order. He is neither male nor female. So He can look to the interests of both, males and females. A male cannot imagine the feelings of a female. A female cannot have, you know, the understanding of the feelings of the male. Capital would look for its own benefits. Labor, it will strive for its own benefits. Rulers will wish to have more and more and more and more authority. And the people should want to have more and more and more and more freedom. We want to go on the streets naked. Who are you to stop us? Freedom. We want homosexuality. We are gays. Who are you to criticize? But the balance of justice between all these extremes, that is the Deenul Haqq. To establish the Deenul Haqq, those who are faithful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have to be ready to come to the battlefield with the iron in their hand to crush the heads of those who resist. They don't want to let the deen of Allah established. إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Verily Allah is himself very powerful. He could do it in no time. But then, how would those who say we are believers, how will they be tested? This is only for your testing. Otherwise, in no time, kun fayakun, one command from him is sufficient. This whole system of falsehood will vanish like anything. And the system of justice will be established. Al-Qawi, Al-Aziz, Inna Allaha Qawiyun Aziz. He is powerful, he has all the authority. He can do it in no time. But it's a test for you. Who are those faithful servants of Allah who devote their lives, ready to spend their lives and all belongings to the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to establish the system of justice which He gave to humanity through His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah give us the courage to join this group, to be one of them, to make a resolve that we have to live for this and die for this. We have read 25 ayat of Surah Al-Hadeed. First 6 ayat refer to the person and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the highest academic level, then 2 demands. Aminu anfiqu. Then, why do you not have faith? A rebuke. If you feel, actually, you don't have the real faith, turn to Quran. Second rebuke, why don't you spend for the cause of Allah? And in that, if the conditions are bad, there is no hope for the establishment of the deen of Allah, still you spend for the deen of Allah, your energies, your life, your time, and your belongings, you will have greater regard than those who will be doing it after the attainment of victory. Then, what is the objective of it? And that is to establish the system of justice on earth, given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for that, a stage might come when you have to go to the battlefield. But that is the last stage. For that, first of all, there should be some propagation of the ideology. Then whosoever accept it, organize them, train them. And when this process reaches a certain level, then only you can challenge the system. But the final point has been mentioned. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. The same thing as we read in Surah Al-Shura. وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. I have been sent to establish justice among you. I am not a soothsayer or a sermon sayer or a poet or a storyteller, nothing of the sort. I have been sent to establish justice. For this is the essence. Now there is a mistake also. When you are told that this life is nothing, real life is of akhirah, of the hereafter, then sometimes there is a tendency for what we call ascetism, rahbaniyat. Leave this world. Why marrying? Why having family life? Why bothering for all these things? Go to some caves or somewhere else, solitary places. Just remember your Lord. Have tried to have a communion with Him. But this is wrong. Islam says you don't love this world. But you have to change this world. Live here. Change it. You have to be an activist, not a passive rahib. An ascetic, passive ascetic, sitting aside from the world. He doesn't care whether there are injustices being done who are here, oppressions are being done who are here, though he doesn't care. He is there in his monastery or something else, sitting over there. No, 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 this is not Islam. So this actually was a mistake committed by the followers of one of the ulul azm min ar-rusul, and that was Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. People who came to believe in him, they twisted their religion towards Rahbaniyat, ascetism. So this mistake is pointed out here in the remaining four ayat of this surah. And for that purpose, Allah starts with Nuh. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا وَإِبْرَاهِيمًا And verily we sent Nuh and Ibrahim. وَجَعَلْنَا فِي ذُرِّيَّتِهِمَا النُّبُوَّةَ وَالْكِتَابَ And we placed our prophethood and the book in the progeny of Nuh and Ibrahim. فَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدْ Out of the progeny of the two, there are who are tightly guided. وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ But most of them are transgressors. Now, ثُمَّ قَفَّيْنَا عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ بِرُسُولِنَا Then we meet our messengers to follow in their footsteps. وَقَفَّيْنَا بِعِيسَىٰ بْنِ مَرْيَمْ And we made Isa son of Maryam to follow. وَجَعَلْنَا فِي قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُ رَافَةً وَرَحْمَةً فَعَتَيْنَاهُ الْإِنْجِيلِ And we gave Isa Injil, the Gospel. And we placed in the hearts of those who followed him tenderness and mercy and compassion. This was a special condition, you know, of the Hawariyin of Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. وَرَحْبَانِيَّةَ نِبْتَدَعُوهَا But monasticism and asceticism was something which they invented. مَا كَتَبْنَاهَا عَلَيْهِمْ We have not made it compulsory on them. This was their decision. This was the wrong turn they took. إِلَّا ابْتِغَارِ رِضْوَانِ اللَّهِ We had only made it compulsory for them to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then, when they adopted asceticism, فَمَا رَعَوْهَا حَقَّ رِعَيَتِهَا Then, they could not observe it with the due observance. فَآتَيْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ So we gave to those of among them who had real faith and belief and who came to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that can also be meant over here. To them we gave their reward, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ But most of them are also transgressors. So this is to point out this wrong term. Don't love this world, but live in it. Try to fashion it on the right path. Take it to the justice, system of justice, and establish the deen of Allah over here. This is the test of your faith and your iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa aminu bi rasulihi yutikum kiflani min rahmatihi. Oh, you who profess to believe. Believe in Allah, have fear of Allah, and believe in His messenger. What does it mean? The real conviction that the model for us is the person of Muhammad, we have to follow him. He was not an ascetic. He didn't start a monastic type of system. No. He fought for the cause of Allah. He was an activist. He challenged falsehood. He took his men to the battlefield, led them to the battlefield. So you have to follow him. See how, during the Makki period, he propagated his ideas. Then those who accepted Iman organized them, trained them with the permanent order. Then no retaliation. Whatever persecution comes to you, verbal or physical, you have to take it patiently without any retaliation. But then, when he thought he has now enough strength with him, he challenged the falsehood. The system, the ascendancy of Quraysh, he fought them, and then he established the deen of Allah in the Arabian Peninsula. So this is the model. Don't follow any other model. You have not to follow the model of Jesus. No. Model for you is Muhammad. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا Jesus had his own methodology. But you have to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are the ummah of Muhammad. So here you know, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَآمِنُوا بِرَسُولِهِ Emphasis on Iman, on the Messenger. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَآمِنُوا بِرَسُولِهِ يُوتِكُمْ كِفْلَيْنِ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ Allah will give you twofold from His mercy. وَيَجْعَلَّكُمْ نُورًا تَمْشُونَ بِهِ, and then He will give you the light with which you will be able to walk. To walk in this world also, you need a light, guidance. And to cross that bridge of As-Sirat on the Day of Judgment, you'll be needing a light. Allah will give you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ, whatever shortcomings, Allah will forgive them. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, verily, Allah is forgiving, merciful. لِأَلَّا يَعْلَمَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَلَّا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِّنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ, so that the people of the book should not think that they have now no access over the bounty of Allah. They have the access. They can even now believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come. آمِنُوا بِرَسُولِهِ. You believe in Musa, you believe in Ibrahim, and so on and so forth. Come and believe in Muhammad also. So all the fazl, you know, the gates of fazl, you know, they will be opened. As we read in Surah Bani Israel, أَصَى رَبَّكُمْ أَنْ يَرْحَمَكُمْ وَإِنْ عُدْتُمْ عُدْنَا. Your Lord is ready to have mercy upon you even now. Go you under the shelter of the messengerhood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The gates are open. The Allah yakun ahlul kitab, Allah yaqdiruna ala shayin min fadlillah, wa anna al-fadla biyadillah, yutiya man yasha. The bounty is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's His prerogative. To whom He wants, He grants it. Wallahu zul fadl azim. And definitely Allah is of infinite bounty. Now we come to Surah Al-Mujadilah. The first four ayat of Surah Al-Mujadilah, they discuss a particular issue of family laws. But the rest of the 18 ayat, they give us a picture of two parties. Party of Satan, party of Allah. As we have seen, when you know this da'wah, this call to Allah, and the call to establish this system of justice given by Allah, when this da'wah is given, there's bound to be a resistance. Then there will be a polarization in this society. Some people who come, accept the call, they are ready to devote their lives, even lay down their lives, for the cause of establishing the deen of Allah. They are the party of Allah. Ulaika Hizbullah. They are the party of Allah. And they are those who oppose it, tooth and nail. Even they sacrifice their lives to protect their interests. But they are the party of Shaitan. Ulaika Hizbu Shaitan. Now this has to be identified. This struggle, this conflict. If we have a concept of mazhab, there is no conflict whatsoever. You go to your church, I am going to my mosque. That's all. He is going to the temple, he is going to the synagogue. Nothing. No argument. But regarding the system, a few people here are resenting. These multinationals, what is happening? What happened in Seattle? When at Davos? But these things are to happen. So, when there is the question of system, it's a different matter. When only is a system of belief and a system of some modes of worship and some rites and rituals, and some feasts, well, they're okay, you can have your, I can have mine. But this conflict, if you want to establish the deen of Allah, then there is going to be a conflict. No escape. So this surah mainly, but you know that Hizbu Shaitan consists of two types of people. One are who are openly opposed. The disbelievers, the rejecters of the faith. And there is the other element, the hypocrites, who are legally with the Muslims, with the Hizbullah, but they are the fifth columnist. Fifth column. They look to the interest of the kuffar, working against the interest of Hezbollah. So this is very important surah regarding this. One thing must be clear here. This establishment of the Deen of Allah is not possible without a party. Individuals cannot do it. It's very simple, very logical. An individual can go on calling and calling and calling and calling, but he cannot establish the system of Allah without having a party. If he doesn't get a party, okay, he won't be able to establish. If there was no party available to Nuh alayhi salam, no harm to Nuh. The people were drowned. Muhammad got sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a party. People who were ready to sacrifice their lives, to spend everything they had. So then there was a struggle, there was a conflict, which reached the level of armed conflict. The polarization became complete. Hezbollah versus Hizb al-Shaytan. And then, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the help, and the deen of Allah was established. But party is essential. So first of all, please note that if you have the concept of Islam as that of a deen, you must think that to strive to establish the deen of Allah is farz. Farz-e-ain. It's a duty. It's obligatory. Not something additional. Not something optional. No. It's not like tahajjud. No. It's farz. Like the five prayers. Like the fasting of the month of Ramadan. Number one. And number two, this is the farz which cannot be fulfilled without a party. Just as you cannot pray without wuzu. Wuzu is not required in itself. Wuzu is the precondition, prerequisite for salah. Really what you want to do is salah, prayer. But for that, there is a precondition of wudu. In the same way, the farz is to establish the deen of Allah, to try, strive your hardest to establish the deen of Allah on earth. But the prerequisite that you should be a part of a party, belong to a party. If there's no party, you stand up, call people towards you. They will join hands with you and it will be a party. If you are two, you have to pray in a jama'ah. One is amam, the other is muqtadi. If there are two, you are a party. One is amir, the other is ma'mur. But not without a party. But when this party swells in numbers, and you know their commitment and depth of commitment reaches that level, and you know their determination to sacrifice everything reaches that level, required level, then there is a direct confrontation between haqq and batil, between the truth and the falsehood, between the Hezbollah on one side and the Hizb al-Shaytan on the other. So this distinction between Hezbollah and Hizb al-Shaytan is the main axis of this Surah Mujadilah. But in the first four ayat, as I told, there is a special family laws issue. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها وتشتكي الى الله Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard the words of that woman who pleads with you, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, concerning her husband and makes her plea to Allah. An incident took place. Aus ibn Sabit Ansari radiyallahu anhu, he did zihar with his wife, Khawla bint Salaba. Zihar in the old Arab tradition was that if a husband said to his wife, you are to me like a mother, or like the back of my mother. Now they are separated, divorced, and there can be no, you know, reunion again. That's whatsoever, no way. Complete, permanent separation. Now in a fit of anger, Aus ibn Sabit said this to his wife, Khawla bint Salama. They had children. Now Khawla came to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. She was weeping, crying. What shall I do? What has this my husband done? Where will these children go? How shall I support them? Weeping, crying. Oh, Muhammad, find some way for me. And the Prophet said, I don't find any way. No revelation has come to me up till now. But then the revelation came. And Allah said, لَقَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا. Oh, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily, indeed, Allah has heard the words of that woman who was pleading with you, O Prophet, concerning her husband, and make also she was making pleas to Allah. Oh Allah, open some door for me, oh Allah. Where can I go? So Allah said, we have heard. Wallahu yasma'u tahawurakuma, and Allah was hearing the conversation between you. Inna Allah sami'un basir, verily Allah is all seer and hearer. Now comes the solution. Alladhina yuzahiruna minkum min nisa'ihim. Those of you who say concerning their wives, be as my mother's back. Ma hunna ummahatihim, in ummahatuhum illallahi waladnahum. They are not their mothers. Their mothers are only those who gave birth to them. Wa innahum la yaquluna munkaram min al-qawl. And surely they are saying a very loathsome word. Wazura, and a lie. إِنَّ اللَّهَ الْعَفُوٌ غَفُورٌ. Verily Allah is pardoning, forgiving. وَالَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْ نِسَائِمْ ثُمَّ يَعُودُونَ لِمَا قَالُوا. As for those who do this zihar to their wives, but then they want to take back. فَالتَّحْرِيرُ رَقَبَةٍ مِنْ قَبْلِ يَتَمَاسَّةِ. So one slave has to be freed before the two of them touch one another. This is the fine. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ ذَلِكُمْ تُوَعَذُونَ بِهِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. This is to what you are exhorted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows and He is aware of what you are doing. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ, whosoever cannot free a slave, he doesn't have that much money with him to buy a slave and free, set him free. فَسْيَامُ شَهْرَيْنِ مُتَتَابِعَيْنِ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَتَمَاسَّةِ. So now he has to keep fast for 2 months, consecutive months, before the two of them touch one another. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ, and if somebody is sick, ill, diabetic, for example, and he can't do it, فَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ فَإِطْعَامُ سِتِّينَ مِسْكِينًا, then he should feed 60 indigent persons. ذَلِكَ لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. And this is so that you should know and be convinced that you have the real faith in Allah and His Messenger. وَتِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ. And these are the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And for the disbelievers, there is a very painful chastisement. Now these are the 4 ayat which have a different issue altogether. But now the issue connected with Surah Al-Hadeed, because these 2 surahs are around a pair. Now that conflict between Haqq and Batil, Deen-e-Haqq, and those who oppose it. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَادُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Verily those who oppose Allah and His Messenger. يُحَادُّون is from Hadeed. The same root. Had, Hadeed. Yuhadun, yuhadidun, bab mufala. Innal ladhina yuhadun Allah wa rasulahu, those who oppose, tooth and nail, Allah and His Messenger, kubitu kama kubit al ladhina min qablihim. They will be humiliated as were those humiliated who were before them. Faqad anzalna ayatin bayinat, and we have already sent down very clear revelations. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. And for these believers, there's going to be a humiliating chastisement. يَوْمَ يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا. On the day when Allah will raise them all together, and then He will tell them what they have been doing. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ. Allah had kept a record of their deeds. وَنَسُوا. They had forgotten. Wallahu ala kulli shayin shaheed. And verily Allah is a witness to everything. Alam tara anna Allah ya'lamu ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Don't you know that Allah knows whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. Ma yakunu min najwa salasati. Now this is the fifth columnist portion of the Muslim Ummah, the Munafiqoon. They used to have secret meetings, secret consultations, planning against the Prophet, against the Muslims, going to the Jews, and you know, saying that we will be with you, and so on and so forth. So this secret counseling, Allah knows everything which is in the heavens and the earth. مَا يَكُونُ مِن نَجْوَى صَلَاسَةٍ إِلَّهُ وَرَابِعُونَ. There's nowhere a secret consultation between three of them, but the fourth is Allah. هُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَنَا مَعَكُنْتُ. Wherever you are, He's with you. So you think we are three? No, you are four. Allah is there. وَلَا خَبْسَةٍ إِلَّا وَأَصَادِسُهُمْ. And if they are five, then Allah is the sixth. وَلَا أَدْنَى مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And no less than that. وَلَا أَكْسَرَ. And not more than that. إِلَّا هُوَ مَعَهُمْ أَيْنَمَا كَانُوا. But He is with them wherever they are. Now we had this ayat in Surah Al-Hadid. هُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. Here only the pronoun has changed. هُوَ مَعَهُمْ أَيْنَمَا كَانُوا. ثُمَّ يُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Then on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, He will tell them what they had been doing. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Verily, Allah knows everything. أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِينَ نُهُوا عَنِ النَّجْوَى. Don't you consider those who were forbidden from these secret counselings? This comes in Surah An-Nisa also at some other place. But now these ayat, as I've told you, they were revealed in the last period of the Madani days. ثُمَّ يَعُودُونَ لَمَا نَهُوا عَنْهُ. But they are doing what they were prohibited to do. وَيَتَنَاجَوْنَ بِالْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ وَمَعْصِيَةِ الرَّسُولِ. And they are having secret consultations among themselves for sinning and enmity and disobedience to the Messenger. وَإِذَا جَاؤُوكَ حَيَّوْكَ بِمَا لَمْ يُحْيِكَ بِهِ اللَّهِ. And when they come to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they salute you with what, with which Allah has not saluted you. The salutation in Islam is Assalamu alaikum. These munafiqoon, when they used to come, they should say, Assalamu alaikum, ya ayyuhan nabi. Assam means death. Death to you, O Messenger. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Omitting the lam in between. If somebody said, what have you said? Oh, I said Assalamu alaikum. What has happened to your ears? Go and get the wax out of your ears. I said Assalamu alaikum. But this was their method. وَيَقُولُونَ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ لَوْلَا يُعَذِّبُنَا اللَّهُ بِمَا نَقُولَ. And then they say in their hearts, whatever we have said, why is not Allah chastising us? It means He is not the Prophet of Allah. Had He been the Prophet of Allah, we have insulted Him. Allah should have chastised us immediately. But He is not doing it. It means He is not. This proves He is not the Messenger of Allah. حَسْبُهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ يَسْلَوْنَهَا وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. For them, sufficient is the hell. And they will enter it. So, and it is a very bad and evil destination. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَنَاجَيْتُمْ فَلَا تَتَنَاجَوْا بِالْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ وَمَعْصِيَةِ الرَّسُولِ. O you who believe, if you have ever to consult secretly, your secret consultation should be not for sin or enmity or disobedience of the Rasul, but تَنَاجَوْا بِالْبِرِّ وَالْتَقْوَى. Do this consultation for virtue and piety. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. And fear Allah, to whom you will be gathered anyhow. إِنَّمَا النَّجْوَى مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. This secret counseling, party within party, Hezbollah, but they have a special group in that Hezbollah. So this is conspiring. إِنَّمَا النَّجْوَى مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. This najwa is actually from Satan. لَيَحْزُنُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So that those who believe, they should be hurt. وَلَيْسَ بِضَارِّهِمْ شَيْئًا. But he cannot do any harm to them. إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. But with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And verily, in Allah should all the believers put their whole trust. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ تَفَسَّحُوا فِي الْمَجَالِسِ فَفْسَحُوا يَفْسَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. O you who believe, when it is said to you, make room in the assemblies, then do make room. What used to happen, you know, the Muslims have gathered, the prophets there, some consultation on some matter is continuing. Now these munafiqeen used to sit in one corner, very close to each other, whispering to each other, so that others shouldn't listen. And you know, when it was said, okay, tafassahu fil majalis, open the place between you. Why are you so much grouped together? So, for the believers, it was the commandment. Whenever it is said, make room in the assemblies, do make it room. Allah will make room for you. يَفْصَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَإِذَا قِيلَ نُشُذُوا فَنِشُذُوا. And when it is said, stand, you should stand. When it is said, the assembly is dismissed. The parade is dismissed. Now you go. But they used to keep sitting over there and continuing their, you know, mutual consultations. فَنْشُدُوا يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Allah Ta'ala would exalt those of you who believe and those who have been given the knowledge. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very well knows and is aware of what you are doing. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نَاجَيْتُمُ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. O you who believe, when you have to have a secret meeting with the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these munafiqeen, because they were very wealthy people, to show off that we have a special position, they would say, Ya Rasulullah, I want to say something to you in secrecy. So please give me time. Now, the other congregation thinks that he is very close to the Prophet and Prophet listens to him. So now, to put a check, this order came. When you have to, you want to have a secret and private meeting with the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَدَّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْنَ جِوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. Give alms before your counseling. Give something to the poor before doing this. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَأَطْهَرٌ. This is much better for you and more purer. فَإِن لَمْ تَجِدُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. But if you are very poor, you don't have anything, okay, Allah is forgiving and merciful. For the poor, there is no harm. But those rich munafiqs, if they want to have a secret meeting and hearing with the Prophet ﷺ, they should give something in the way of Allah first and then come. Now those people, they loved wealth like anything. Now they stopped. أَشْفَقْتُمْ أَن تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيَ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. Have you become afraid of giving alms between your secret meeting with the Prophet ﷺ? فَإِذْ لَمْ تَفَعَلُوا, when you didn't do it, وَتَعَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has relented on you, okay? He is giving the concession. فَتَعَبَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ. Now at least establish the salah properly. وَعَتُوا zakah, and do pay zakah definitely. وَعَتِيُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, and obey Allah and His Messenger. وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. I verily, surely Allah is aware of what you are doing. أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا قَوْمًا غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Have you not considered those who have become friends with those on whom there is wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who are they? The Yahud, مَغْزُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. مَغْزُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ Yahud. And these munafiqs, they had friendship with the Yahud. They are, in some cases, working agents to Yahud. أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا قَوْمًا غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا هُمْ مِنْكُمْ وَلَا مِنْهُمْ. These munafis, these hypocrites, are neither from you nor from them. They are sincere to neither you nor them. They are sincere to none. They are not sincere to Allah. They are not sincere to the Messenger of Allah. How can they be sincere to the Jews? But you know, they are after their own gains. وَيَحْلِفُونَ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ. And they take oaths on something which is not true, wrong, and lie. وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ And they do it knowingly. أَعْدَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا Allah has prepared for them a very severe chastisement. إِنَّهُمْ سَاءَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ Verily, it's very evil what they are doing. لَنْ تُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا Neither their riches nor their children will be of any avail for them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ They are the dwellers of the fire and they will remain in that forever. يَوْمَ يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا When Allah will raise them all, فَيَحْلِفُونَ لَهُ كَمَا يَحْلِفُونَ لَكُمْ They will swear before Allah also as they swear before you. وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ عَلَىٰ شَيْءٍ They will be thinking that they are upon something. They have some footing. أَلَىٰ إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ الْكَاذِبُونَ Behold, surely they are the liars. اِسْتَحْبَذَ عَلَيْهِمُ الشَّيْطَانِ Satan has gained the control over them. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ And he has made them forgetful of Allah's remembrance. أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ الشَّيْطَانِ They are the party of shaitan. This party of shaitan consists of two parts. The kuffar, openly, against Islam, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and their agents, hypocrites, among the Muslims. Legally included as Muslims. أَلَا إِنَّ حِزْبَ الشَّيْطَانِ هُمُ الْكَخَاسِرُونَ Behold, definitely the second party, they will be the losers in the long run. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَادُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أُولَٰئِكَ فِي الْأَذَلِّينَ Verily, those who oppose and fight Allah and His Messenger, they will be among the most humiliated ones. كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي Allah has decided and prescribed and written it down. Certainly, I and my messengers will be victorious. This is the divine law about messengers, not about prophets. Prophets were killed also. But no messenger of Allah could be killed. We have read this in Surah As-Saffat. وَلَقَدْ سَبَقَتْ كَلِمَتُنَا لِعْبَادِنَا الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِنَّهُمْ لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ This decision of ours has already passed. That those of our servants whom we appoint as our messengers, definitely they will be helped. And definitely our army will be victorious. So the same thing comes over here. As I told you, important subjects are discussed in Quran at least at two places. So Surah Saffat, and here it is. كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is powerful and mighty, and He has all the authority in His hands. لَا تَجِدُ قَوْمًا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ You will not find those people who really believe in Allah and the last day. يُعَادُّونَ مَنْ حَادَّ اللَّهِ Loving those who oppose Allah وَرَسُولَهُ and His Messenger. وَلَوْ كَانُوا آبَاهُمْ Although they might be their fathers, أَوْ أَبْنَاهُمْ or their sons, أَوْ إِخْوَانُهُمْ or their brothers, أَوْ أَشِيرَتُهُمْ or their kindred, أُولَٰئِكَ كَتَبَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْإِيمَانِ They are the people in whose hearts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inscribed and engraved iman. وَيَّدَهُمْ بِرُوحِ مِنْهُ And has helped them with a spirit from him. That is Jibreel, بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ وَيُدْخِرُهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ And he will make them enter and admit them in the gardens underneath which the rivers will be flowing. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ Allah will be pleased with them. وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ And they will be pleased with him. أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ اللَّهِ They are the party of Allah. Now this is the polarization. On the basis of Allah and His Messenger. People who have belief in Allah and Messenger to this side. Those who don't believe on the other side. Even if he is your father, he is enemy of Allah, you can't love him, you can't have any relation with him. Even if he is your brother. وَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاهُمْ آبَاهُمْ وَأَبْنَاهُمْ أَوْ إِخْوَانَهُمْ أَوْ أَشِيرَتَهُمْ Whosoever he might be. This polarization has to be complete. so that Hezbollah, it becomes absolutely pure and free. Ulaika Hezbollah. Now this word Hezbollah appears in this surah and also in Surah Al-Ma'idah. فَإِنَّ عِزْبَاللَّهِ هُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ In Surah Al-Ma'idah, غَالِبُونَ The party of Allah will be dominant, will be victorious, will be supreme. And here, أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ Verily, the Hezbollah, they are going to be the prosperers and successors. فَلَا is for the hereafter. And ghalaba, domination, is in this world. So there are two promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Hezbollah. Number one, in this world, they will be helped and Allah will give them the victory. فَإِنَّ حِزْبَاللَّهِ هُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ This is in Surah Ma'idah. And there are the Hezbollah, أَلَا إِنَّ حِزْبَاللَّهِ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ Verily, the people who belong to the Hezb of Allah, only they are going to succeed. Now let me, because I have 2 minutes, let me give you the hadith. The importance of this jama'ah. There's a hadith. Inni amurukum bi khamsin. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Verily, O Muslims, I command you 5 things. Allahu amarani bihinna. And I'm not doing it on my own. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me to do so. What are those 5 things? Bil jama'ate, party. You must belong to a party. Was sam'i, and to listen to the leader of the party. Was ta'ate, and obeying the decisions of the party. Wal jihad fi sabil, wal hijra, and making hijra in the way of Allah. Wal jihad fi sabilillah. And then you can make jihad fi sabilillah. Jihad fi sabilillah essential. As we read yesterday in Surah Al-Hujurat, if there's no jihad, there's no iman. It's the necessary constituent of iman. Innama al-mu'minuna allazeena amanu billahi wa rasulihi thumma lam yartabu wa jahadu bi amwalihim wa anfusihim fi sabilillah. Ulaika humus sadiqun. Verily the true Muslims are only those who believe in Allah and His Messenger, then doubt not. And then they do jihad in the way of Allah with their belongings and their lives. This jihad, for that you need a party. This party should be a very disciplined party. Some ta'at, listen and obey. To Anil Haris al-Ash'ariya radiyallahu ta'ala an, ta'ala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inni amurukum bi khamsin, Allahu amarani bihinna, بالجماعت والسمع والطاعت والهجرت والجهاد في سبيل الله. This hadith has been included by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal in his Musnad. Also Imam Tirmidhi in his Jami'. And this thing has gone out of our sight and out of our mind. We don't feel something lacking. Are you involved in the struggle of Iqamatuddin or not? If yes, with what group? Which party? If you don't have any party, existing party, go on. You can form a party of your own. All the parties today which are present, they are also, none of them is led by a Nabi. There's no Nabi. No Nabi after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you can have the... You are also not a Nabi. Okay, go ahead. And you can have a party. But without party, لا إسلام إلا بالجماعة. This is the saying of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And the saying of a messenger, of a companion of the messenger is also called Hadith. This is Hadith. And no less a companion than Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The second topmost sahabi. لا إسلام إلا بالجماعة. ولا جماعة إلا بالإمارة. ولا إمارة إلا بالسماعة. ولا سماعة إلا بالطاعة. No Islam without Jama'ah. No Jama'ah without Amir, Imara. No use of having an Amir without listening to him. And no use of listening to him if you are not obeying him. May Allah give us the right guidance and give us the correct understanding of our duties as Muslims. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.